Hey there, welcome back to the channel. In today's video we are going to look at the following WWE news and rumors. Sasha Banks fired from WWE. Naomi deletes Twitter account after getting blamed online for Jimmy's DUI arrest. WWE starts an innovative mode of hiring and rehire Braun Strowman. Be sure to stick around for all the latest WWE news and rumors. Don't forget to drop a like and subscribe for daily wrestling content. In a massive development that should have been avoided, Naomi deleted her Twitter handle due to several social media trolls blaming her for her husband Jimmy's latest DUI arrest. She was subjected to several baseless accusations and comments from an ill-advised section of the Twitter wrestling universe, forcing her to deactivate her profile abruptly. The former SmackDown Women's Champion's Twitter handle is still not accessible as of this writing, and any attempt to get to her account will result in this page popping up. As reported via TMZ a few days ago, Jimmy was arrested on yet another DUI charge. The cops caught him breaking the speed limit with a blood alcohol concentration of 0.205. He was detained and slapped with a release bond of $500. Jimmy has had an unsatisfactory history with DUI-related charges. His most recent arrest was not what WWE management wanted during Roman Reigns' high-profile Samoan family saga. As revealed first by WrestleVotes, high-ranking WWE officials were said to have been very disappointed in Jimmy, however. The company didn't noticeably punish him on the last SmackDown show as he got up more TV time than usual. Fightful Select added to WrestleVotes' report and confirmed that Jimmy had heat from high-level people in the WWE following the DUI incident. While the tag team specialist's on-screen status could also be in jeopardy, his recent actions have severely affected Naomi's personal and social life. Many current WWE superstars voiced their support for the former Funkadactyl, while also shutting down people who irrationally targeted her for Jimmy's mistakes. Naomi's colleagues from WWE stood by her side as she received many reassuring messages on social media. Naomi is one of the most cheerful performers in all of WWE, and the misplaced blame directed towards her has resulted in a deplorable situation. WWE is a publicly traded company and a recognized leader in global entertainment. It has over 800 full-time employees and a plethora of superstars, anchors, referees, etc. working for them on a contractual basis. WWE is always looking to hire new personnel to keep improving the quality of the product and cater to the needs of the viewers. The traditional way of becoming a WWE superstar would be to join a wrestling school, working on the independent circuit, attending a WWE tryout, and taking it from there. Now there's another way to do that. TikTok has started a pilot program in which a user can apply their resume for a company of their choosing. TikTok has partnered with multiple companies, including WWE. However, as of this video, the pilot program only lasts until July 31, 2021. Possibly the most flabbergasting WWE decision of all time, Braun Strowman's WWE release makes no sense. WWE found themselves the perfect giant wrestler in the form of Strowman. Not only was he freakishly strong, he was also intimidating and scary. Something that a lot of other giants lack, Strowman was also athletic in the ring, which meant that his matches were superb as well. It was also not like WWE had not noticed that. The company pushed the superstar to the moon and back as he dominated every superstar that he came across. For a long time, he was the only star who could destroy Roman Reigns in the way that he did. Be it the awesome feats of strength WWE showcased for him, or the way that the company booked him, it shocked the WWE universe to their very core when he was released. WWE needs to hire Braun Strowman back as he may be one of the best giant wrestlers in the world today. The monster among men has gotten into the best shape of his life, and the company would do themselves a favor if they decided to bring him back into the company in the position that he always deserved. Brock Lesnar hasn't been seen on WWE television since WrestleMania 36 in 2020. In his last match for the company, he lost to Drew McIntyre in the main event of WrestleMania 36 in the Performance Center behind closed doors. Since then, he hasn't made his return, and his on-screen advocate Paul Heyman has aligned with Roman Reigns on SmackDown. PW Insider reported in late August 2020 that Brock Lesnar's WWE contract had expired, with neither party making an effort to renew it. Former WWE and UFC champion Brock Lesnar is currently a free agent as his most recent deal with World Wrestling Entertainment has expired without the two sides locking in a new contract. Rather than Brock Lesnar outright leaving WWE, his contract simply expired. The company didn't make an effort to start the dialogue, It was reportedly because WWE didn't want Lesnar, a larger-than-life megastar, wrestling in the Performance Center in front of no audience. It marked the end of an 8-year run for Brock Lesnar in WWE. He made his return to the company in 2012 on the Raw after WrestleMania 28. Under his WWE contract, Brock Lesnar competed at WrestleMania every year. The big question has always been about when Brock Lesnar will return to WWE. A few years ago, there would have been a lot of speculation about Lesnar returning to UFC. From the look of things, that chapter of his life is over. Brock Lesnar's negotiations with UFC resulted in Vince McMahon offering a lucrative contract. Brock Lesnar is expected to return to WWE at some point in 2021. Normally, Brock Lesnar only wrestles in select pay-per-views, such as the Royal Rumble, WrestleMania, and SummerSlam. In recent years, he has appeared in WWE's Saudi Arabia shows as well. Andrew Zarain of the Matt Men podcast revealed that the only hurdle for Brock Lesnar's return to WWE is a storyline in place for him, and not a contractual issue. Despite WWE making massive cuts last year, the company usually doesn't compromise when it comes to offering Brock Lesnar a satisfactory contract. Zarain revealed that Lesnar's WWE return is inevitable, as have several other reports from different outlets. Sasha Banks was in the historic main event of WrestleMania 37 where she went up against Bianca Belair and overnight, made her into the future of women's wrestling. Even though the EST of WWE has gone on to do great things since then, she hasn't had the opportunity to square off with the boss again. Sasha Banks' absence has prompted many to ask whether she is still employed by the company. Fear not, for the answer is a resounding yes. Bianca Belair has made her intentions for a rematch very clear indeed. This is what she told Sports Illustrated during an exclusive interview about the WrestleMania 37 match, also a potential rematch. "That moment was bigger than us," Belair added. "Even though I won the title, no one lost that night. That's why there are videos of Sasha smiling at the end. She had so much fulfillment from what came out of that match. Now, when she comes back and the title is on the line, we'll see who walks out as champion." As for Sasha Banks herself, she earned quite a bit of acclaim through her role in The Mandalorian. She is quite thrilled to be a part of the Star Wars franchise, and one has to believe that this could lead to more acting opportunities. As for when she will be back, Sasha Banks has been public about how excited she is to be back on the road again. Maybe Sasha Banks comes back next week, as one of the contestants in the Money in the Bank ladder match. Maybe she comes back closer to SummerSlam, for that rematch with Bianca Belair for the WWE SmackDown Women's Championship, but to answer the initial question, she is very much a part of WWE.